The conference spoke to areas such as judicial efficiency, which entails a review of the court's operations over the past decades. Legal Affairs Minister Victor Lecorbiniere suggested that bar associations, along with non-government organizations and citizens, engage in discussion over what direction the court system should take. He says this is vital if the legal system is to become effective. He called for the expediting of judgments and the full electronic management of commercial and intellectual property.
When we speak of these things, this is not simply to have something that is new and something that is novel. When some of these came in a few years ago, people thought, oh, this was something for the future. But the global nature of our world today requires this. When an investor is sitting in the United States or in Eastern Europe or in Western Europe and wants to start up an operation in St. Lucia or Grenada or Antigua, as the case may be, he must now be able to start doing a lot of his basic work, even as he sits in his own home country. This is where the world has gone. And if we do not keep a pace, what will happen is that those jurisdictions that are keeping a pace will outrun us.
The minister says it's time that the St. Lucia justice system keeps pace with the rest of the world. Authorities fear foreign investors will be reluctant to invest in St. Lucia if they sense that the judiciary system is too slow, and the minister believes that this is one of the main reasons why St. Lucia has declined in the index of doing good and efficient business. Officials say the conference has a vision to strengthen the backbone of the court.
I hope that in the future, some way can be found to share some of this academic bounty with other members of the legal profession with whom you registrars and court administrators have to interact on a daily basis, not forgetting those in the AG's chambers, of course. All of you with first-hand experience in your respective registries have the common goals of crafting a better future for our legal systems and ultimately the economies of our countries. I believe that your presence here today and that of the judiciary clearly demonstrates the court's acknowledgement of you as an important aspect of the entire judicial process.
Officials say the state of a country's judiciary system is a strong indicator of its economic health, and they say the registry is the gateway to the court. According to them, there is where the trial process begins. Authorities also sought to dispel certain misconceptions about the Eastern Caribbean Supreme Court.
There is a long-standing misperception, in my view, even among court officers, that St. Lucia houses only the Court of Appeal. But in fact, St. Lucia is the headquarters of the Eastern Caribbean Supreme Court. The Eastern Caribbean Supreme Court is a court of 9 member states and territories because it exercises one single jurisdiction throughout those 9 states and territories. Indeed, the Supreme Court order, Section 9, states, among other things, that the process of the Supreme Court shall run throughout the states.
The conference also spoke to financial constraints plaguing the courts. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.